Complaints are pouring in surrounding the state's food stamp disaster assistance program, better known as DSNAP. Hundreds of people in Orleans and Jefferson parishes are sounding off about how the program is being run. Up until now, people could go to any parish to get their designated letter day. But because the deadline is approaching, today people were required to go to their specified parish. Victims standing in long lines for hours complained of the heat, their health, and what they call an unorganized system.
I'm 68 years old, crippled in one leg, on a cane, and under cancer treatment. And I'm standing in the sun about to pass out.
We do have a special line for elderly and disabled to get them out of the heat as quickly as possible. We have tents available. We provide water and refreshments. We're trying our best to make sure that people are taken care of.
And Williams says tomorrow is the last day for people in Orleans and Jefferson parishes to apply for disaster food stamps at the UNO Lakefront Arena and Alario Center. You must go to your specific parish. Williams says the state is looking at an extension, but no decisions have yet been made. And the crowds converging to apply for disaster food assistance are causing headaches for surrounding businesses. WDSU anchor LaTanya Norton spoke with one business owner who says she's not making money even after the storm.
And we're here on Franklin Avenue, right across the street from the UNO Lakefront Arena. I am joined by Ms. Karen Battow. She is a restaurant owner, the owner of Quiznos here on Franklin Avenue. And tell us about the situation you're in. You told me a little bit earlier today that 7 days now you had to close because of Hurricane Isaac. And now with a lot of people arriving to the UNO Lakefront Arena to apply for disaster food stamp assistance, that's adding another worry on your plate, so to speak.
Yes, ma'am. Like you said, we've been closed for 7 days due to Isaac, lost anywhere from $12,000 to $15,000 in revenue. And now we're dealing with this situation. We understand that people need assistance. We do understand that. But we think and we feel, and I can speak for the rest of these business owners in the area, that this should have been thought out a whole lot better.
The bottom line is you've already lost a lot of money, and
yes,
in your opinion, you're losing more because of this program and its location, keeping your customers from getting to you.
Yes, ma'am. UNO's back at school. Today's a day we'd be doing $2,000 or $3,000 a day. We're doing nothing right now. It's dead.
Karen, thank you so much for joining us. Once again, frustration from one business owner representing several business owners in this area. Once again, we're across the street from the UNO Lakefront Arena. We're on Franklin Avenue. It's the place where many victims of Hurricane Isaac, they're coming here to apply for disaster food stamp assistance. They need somewhere to park. They're using the parking lot over here, which is convenient, but it's keeping some business owners from getting the customers they desperately need. On your side, LaTanya Norton, WDSU News.
The state is also trying to help out businesses who were affected in Hurricane Isaac. There are now 5 new business recovery centers open. The centers in Jefferson, Orleans, and St. Tammany parishes are open on Monday and Tuesdays. The center in St. Bernard Parish is open Monday through Friday. Staff will be able to answer questions on disaster loans to finance the recovery of your business. In